Hey everybody and welcome back to my channel. I'm Ian Campbell and today we are going to be talking about how to get sponsored. So sponsorships and questions around sponsorships are always something that I get on my Instagram and on the YouTube channel, and people just wanting to know how to get sponsored. This is quite a long topic and one that I feel like I should discuss with you guys just to let you know exactly what it takes to get sponsored, how you can stay sponsored, and what are the different levels and stages in your sponsorships that you can obtain from companies. First of all, I want to discuss what a sponsorship deal actually is and, you know, how you go about trying to get these deals from people. So there's a number of different stages to sponsorships. You can have product reviews where you go and test products and run like a research and development and R&D for people. You can do a monetary based sponsorship where you get paid a fee in order to promote their products and to try and build their brand up. Or three, you just get flowed product and you test their product out, you ride their product and tell everyone about whatever the product is. One thing to learn from this video is these relationships are very much give and take. It is either you are giving them a service where you are providing something for them and in return they are giving you product, or you're providing them some marketing in order for their product to get sold more. A big thing that I tell people when they ask me this question is, you guys have got to realize that these companies are trying to make money. They are trying to get as much money out of their products as they can and build their brand as big as they can. It's not always about the person with the most following on Instagram or the person who can edit the best videos, but it's the person that is listened to the most. So for instance, if I'm going to go down to the beach and I look at the waves and the waves are pretty bad and I'm like, I'll just go out and surf anyway, and a bunch of people join me, I am influencing those people to get in the water. And that is a very good way for brands to look at people and how they influence the market. If they can influence people to then buy the product, that is where you want, and that is the person you want to portray to companies so that they look at you as that influencing factor around people buying certain products. So the next thing I want to say is, when you are approaching these companies, approach them with an idea in mind. Either you want to help them with product development, you want to help them sell more product, or alternatively you want to get your own signatures on products and earn a royalty off it, or just a percentage of the sale. Or there's so many different aspects to this, and you guys are gonna have to do your research to find cool and innovative ways to approach these companies. Another thing I must say is, when you are approaching these companies, either message the Instagram pages or find their website and go on there and try and find the contact person who is either doing athlete management or marketing. Those are the people you're going to want to talk to. Try and converse with them over email. This is just a way more professional way of going about it. And identify some products that you are going to want to sell for them. So if you go into their catalogs, look at their different boards, or look at their fins, or look at their leashes, or their clothing line, or their shoes, or whatever it is that you are going to be trying to get sponsored by, try and figure out a little bit of the products that they use and how they use them and what's so good about them. This will show them that you are interested in their products, or you've used their products, or you know about the brand, and it's just gonna make their life easier. When it comes to reporting back, report back to these people every month, or once you've written the product, or different things that you're feeling about these products, and let them know how you feel. Let them know where the goods are, where the bads are, and try and build that relationship. These deals are all about relationships. Throughout the years, I have been so fortunate to be with companies like Sniper and Churchill, SunZapper and Red Bull, who have all been there for 3, 4, 5 years. I mean, Red Bull came on when I first started my career as a bodyboarder on the international level, and they've been with me ever since, providing a little bit of funding at times and really helping me through the ways. So try and build those relationships with the key people at the top, and this will make their life easier, it'll make your life easier, and it'll be a lot easier to communicate with them well. The last point I want to discuss about that is just be yourself. Don't try and be someone that you're not. I am a very professional person. I write, report to my sponsors every single month, and that's how I was taught to be a professional, and that is the kind of thing that I add on top of everything that I do for the brands. I let them know exactly what I've been doing every month so that they know where their money is going. If they don't know where their money is going, they're going to start to doubt you or think different or not really see as much of an influence that you are putting on people. This way, if you're telling them exactly what you're doing, where you're going, what your plans are, they know exactly where you're going, and they don't have to keep checking up on you every single month to see if you're doing the right things. Another point that I want to bring up is you've got to find things within your industry. Now, it is all good and well you looking at a shoe sponsor if you're a bodyboarder, and that's not really going to work. Try find brands that are doing boards, fins, wetsuits, and anything within the industry that makes sense. If it doesn't make sense, like you going to get a bicycle sponsor for a bodyboarder, it's not really gonna fit, and that's not gonna work out and make sense in the long run. In your proposal that you write to these people, remember to be very specific. You want to tell them exactly what you're looking for, what you're going to do to help this brand. And that is always the key thing. You need to tell them exactly what you want to do in order to better their brand. A lot of people look at these deals, especially when it comes from a younger person trying to get into the market and trying to break through. A lot of the time, you are going to want to just get product or just get money from them straight up, but you need to actually tell these people exactly what you want to do with the product so that they know that their money is not just getting wasted on constantly providing product and not getting anything back. This is a very much a give and take, as I've said before, and you guys need to learn that in order for the sponsorships to work for a long period of time. The last thing I want to talk about is growth. Now, you're going to want to grow with these sponsors as they grow down the line. For me, I have been able to grow my sponsorships throughout the years and demand more money or demand more product from these different companies. For instance, Churchill, when I first started with them, they gave me a very small budget and they gave me a large amount of product to kind of balance the two off. And through the years of working with them and showing them how worth it I actually am, I've taken that product from being a very big load of product with a small amount of cash to being a bigger amount of cash and about the same amount of product. So you need to build with these companies. You need to show them your worth and help them. You don't want them to be struggling along the way but still paying you huge amounts of money. You want to be trying to sell their product, trying to get their name out there and build them up as you build up. It's very much about helping these companies to sell a lot of product, make revenue, and then in turn, you will reap the benefits from trying to build these brands up and putting their product out there and getting more money into the company. So guys, I hope this makes a little bit more sense on how to get sponsorships and how to actually look within your industry to try and find deals that makes sense to you. Whether they are product deals where you're just getting flowed product and you're putting their name out there, or whether you want to do product reviews where you take their product and you try it out and you let them know how it goes, or alternatively, if you're trying to get money from people and get onto a salary of these companies to try and help them in their marketing and sales. It doesn't matter what it is, it's all the same process. Try to be as professional as possible and try and make their jobs easier. If you have any other questions, please feel free to hit me up on my Instagram. I am probably most active on there and will answer any questions that you guys have. And please hit the like button if you enjoy these videos, and if you want to see more of this kind of stuff, leave a comment down below, as well as subscribe and hit that notification bell to be notified first. Please, if you guys have any more questions, leave them down in the comment section below and I will try and answer them as soon as I can. I hope everyone is staying safe, staying healthy, and we'll see you in the next video.